I'm Bernadette Peters. Join me tonight for a celebration of Stephen Sondheim's music performed by the New York Philharmonic with guest vocalist Katrina Lenk. It starts in just a moment on Live from Lincoln Center.
Welcome to David Geffen Hall in New York City. I'm Fred Child, glad to ring in the new year with you live from Lincoln Center. The New York Philharmonic is warming up and tuning up. Guest vocalist Katrina Lenk will make her New York Philharmonic debut in just a few minutes. Conductor Alexander Gemignani also making his debut. Let's begin with music from 1962.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Bernadette Peters.
Hello. And good evening, and welcome to our New Year's Eve celebration of the music of my friend, Stephen Sondheim. The occasion is particularly special for me as I was lucky enough to be cast in four of his Broadway musicals, many of which are being represented on this stage tonight. As you may know, the New York Philharmonic is no stranger to Steve, having given concert productions of Follies Company and Sweeney Todd, but this program is different. Though he is both a composer and a lyricist, tonight we are going to focus specifically on his music. There will be no Mrs. Lovett singing Shepherd's Pie peppered with actual shepherd on top, or Joanne and Company warning Bobby that his new girlfriend is tall enough to be your mother, not even a witch, cackling to a baker and his wife that there's no more fuss and there's no more scenes and my garden thrives. You should see my nectarines. But I'm telling you the same myself, kings and queens. Never, ever, ever mess around with my greens. Especially the beans. No, none of that. Aside from two songs sung by the brilliant Katrina Lenk, it's the New York Philharmonic's Night to Shine. And the orchestra will be playing orchestral suites and overtures, as well as symphonic treatments of some of Sondheim's most beautiful songs. For example, here is a suite from Stephen James Lapine's Into the Woods, without interference from a witch, arranged and orchestrated by Don Sebesky.
Thank you.
Now we are going to hear the premiere of a new orchestral suite from Steve and John Weidman's Assassins, a sort of surreal vaudeville review featuring nine of the assassins who, across a span of 100 years of American history, tried to kill the President of the United States, from John Wilkes Booth to Lee Harvey Oswald. The score uses styles from various periods of American music. The suite has been arranged and orchestrated by Michael Starobin, the original orchestrator of the show. Ladies and gentlemen, assassins. Ladies and gentlemen, the orchestrator of Assassins is with us tonight, Michael Starobin. There he is. One of my favorites of Steve's scores is the one from Company. A show he wrote with George Firth. Like Assassins, Company is a review of sorts, although it has a story. It takes place in the early 1970s, and instead of being about politics, it's about the difficulty of maintaining relationships in a society becoming increasingly depersonalized. It has two central characters: Robert, a man unable to make an emotional commitment, and New York City. The iconic song, Being Alive, at the climax of the show was not the original one written for that moment. It was the third. But, as I'm sure you know, musicals are not so much written as rewritten. Here is an orchestral version of one of the songs that preceded Being Alive, a rhapsodic love song that the hero Robert sings about Amy, the girl he thinks he loves. It's called Multitudes of Amys, here arranged and orchestrated by Don Sebesky. 1970s were a prolific time for Steve. Company, Follies, A Little Night Music, Pacific Overtures, and then, to finish out the decade, Sweeney Todd. In New York alone, this musical has been performed on Broadway, at City Opera, twice right here on this stage with the Philharmonic, once with actor musicians, and most recently, downtown at a theater converted into a pie shop. No matter what the scale or the venue, Sweeney Todd is spectacular. Here's a suite of the score again in an arrangement and orchestration by Don Sobeski.
Thank you.
In 1973, Steve and Hal Prince decided they wanted to do a romantic musical. Together with Hugh Wheeler, they chose to adapt Ingmar Bergman's romantic comedy Smiles of a Summer Night and called it A Little Night Music. In order to keep the sense of romance afloat, Steve composed the score entirely in variations of triple meter, waltzes, minuets, polonaises, and so forth. The show contains Steve's most popular song, Send in the Clowns, and I was lucky enough to get to sing it in the most recent Broadway revival. Here is one of the orchestral waltzes from the score, The Night Waltz, orchestrated by Steve's longtime collaborator, Jonathan Tunick. Next up is a piece from Steve and James Goldman's breathtaking Follies, a show about former Follies showgirls attending a reunion at the theater they once performed in, which is about to be torn down. The score is in part pastiche, filled with homages to great composers from between the two world wars, including Irving Berlin, Cole Porter, and George Gershwin. We are going to hear the overture, which serves to introduce the themes of each of the characters as they arrive at the reunion. Once again, orchestrated by the great Jonathan Tunick. often says that one of the things he loves most about the theater is that it allows his shows to be reconceived in fresh ways. Sweetie Todd in a Pie Shop, or played by a small cast of actor musicians, or as in London last year, a revival of Company by the imaginative director Marianne Elliott, which swapped some of the genders of the characters. Happily, it's coming to Broadway this season. And the leading role of Bobby, now female and spelled with an I-E, will be played by the dazzling Tony Award-winning Katrina Lenk. She is with us tonight to sing two of Steve's great songs from Follies. Ladies and gentlemen, Katrina Lenk.
The coffee cup, I think about you. I want you so. It's like I'm losing my mind. The morning ends, I think about you. I talk to friends, I think about you. And do they know? It's like I'm losing my mind. All afternoon doing every little chore, the thought of you stays bright. Sometimes I stand in the middle of the floor, not going left, not going right. I dim the lights and think about you. Spend sleepless nights to think about you. You said you loved me, or were you just being kind? Or am I losing my mind? Like I'm losing my mind. Does no one know? It's like I'm losing my mind. The thought of you stays bright. Sometimes I stand in the middle of the floor, not going left, not going right. I dim the lights and think about you. Spend sleepless nights to think about. Or Am I losing my
Could I bury my rage with a boy half your age in the grass? Bet your ass, but I've done that already. Oh, didn't you know, love? Tell me, how could I leave when I left long ago? Leave me the flat, leave me the Brocks and Chagalls and all that. You could leave me the stocks for sentiment's sake, and 90% of the money you make, and the rocks and the cooks. Darling, you keep the drugs, Angel, you keep the books. Honey, I'll take the grand sugar, you keep the spinach and all of our friends. And just wait a goddamn minute. Oh, leave you. Could I leave you? Yes. Will I leave you? Will I leave you? Guess.
Thank you.
Before we say goodnight, I think we should thank our conductor, Alexander Gemignani, making his New York Philharmonic debut. Above all, what other word can I use? The monumental New York Philharmonic. For our finale, a suite from one of the most exhilarating pieces of theater ever. And I don't say that just because I was part of it. It's Stephen James Lapine's Sunday in the Park with George. Inspired by the French pointillist painter Georges Seurat's painting A Sunday Afternoon on the Island of La Grande Jatte. The show is about the wonders of creativity. And there's a lyric in the show which reflects how I feel about Steve and his work. Anything you do, let it come from you. Then it will be new. Give us more to see. Sunday in the Park with George, arranged and orchestrated by Michael Starobin.
Thank you.
encore from the New York Philharmonic as they're celebrating Stephen Sondheim tonight on this New Year's Eve. That's the overture from Merrily We Roll Along, the 1981 musical by Stephen Sondheim. Our conductor, Alexander Gemignani, making his New York Philharmonic debut tonight with, by the way, tips from his dad, Paul Gemignani, who is the musical director for Stephen Sondheim for 45 years. Join the conversation on Twitter using the hashtag LFLC. You can also watch a conversation between Paul and Alexander Gemignani on PBS.org. Merry New Year and Happy Christmas from all of us at Live from Lincoln Center.